Chow and you're watching PTO classes. So I'm back with another lesson from grade 9th English, and today we are going to read one more chapter from Beehive. So this story is a very emotional one, and it has happened with lot many of us. We get attached with a lot of humans, but sometimes we get even more attached with animals. So you must also have a pet around, or you must also have some dog, street dog, a cat around your home that you feed, that you feel, that you share a bond with. Okay, so this bond that we share with these animals who can't express themselves like us, we call it the bond of love. So this bond of love is present around us, and it makes our life more happy. The bond of love that is there in the story is a very emotional one, a very unreal one that you are going to enjoy a lot. It may invoke a lot of feelings inside you. A few person are there who don't like spending much time with the animals, with the creatures who are not like us, who can't express themselves. They like to hit them, they like to torture them, but that is very bad and a very sad thing. So I hope that after reading The Bond of Love, this story will develop some kind of a of humanitarian emotions in you, that you will be more you will be more humanistic with the animals also. You will be more polite with them, you will respect them, you will, at least you will not harm them. Those who can't hit you back, those who can't harm you back, you should always avoid harming them. Yes, we say that dogs bite us or they are harmful, but they only hurt you when you hurt them. If you will create a bond of love, then they will always have only good feelings for you, and they will never harm you. So let's together read this story, The Bond of Love, and let's see what the story holds. We are going to do the word meanings of this chapter in this video, in this part, and we will divide the story in two parts. In today's lecture, we are going to complete the part one, and you are going to do the word meanings. In the next part, I am going to conclude the chapter, and you will do the questions that are there in the chapter. So without wasting much time, let's see what is there in the story. And yes, I forgot to tell you, the author of the story is Kenneth Anderson. Okay, Kenneth Anderson, what can I say about him? He is an Indian origin, Indian born, British origin writer, author, who has written many good stories, many emotional stories, many realistic stories. So you can find them easily in the net. And for today, we are having The Bond of Love. Let's together unveil what is there in the story.
Okay class, so now we are going to read the chapter, The Bond of Love. And as I have told you, this story is based on the friendship, the relationship between human beings and animals. So the bond that is created between us is very beautifully explained in the story. And together we will now explore it, explore the friendship between them, between us. And I really hope that you will enjoy it. So let's begin. Before you read, can there be love and friendship between human beings and wild animals? Of course. Let's read a fascinating account of an orphan sloth bear, the black bear, that was rescued by the author. Sloth bears inhabit forested areas. They live in the forested areas, including the tropical rainforest of India. Sloth bears have very shaggy hair, very long fuzzy hair and long muzzles. Using their claws to dig, they can then use their lips to form a tube which can go deep into the ground to suck into the areas of dead trees for food, like insect and everything. They eat it through their lips. Their main food is termites. They love termites. You can hear them suck up their food from several feet away. So they like sucking up from the tree trunk, and this is their favorite dish, the termite. So let's read the story. I will begin with Bruno, my wife's pet sloth bear. I got him for her by an accident. So the writer, the author, Kenneth Anderson, he's telling us that he will begin by describing us that who Bruno was. Bruno was a sloth bear that he got for his wife by an accident. 2 years ago, we were passing through the sugarcane fields near Mysore. Okay, the author is telling how he got the bear. 2 years ago, they were passing through Mysore. People were driving away the wild pigs from the fields, shooting at them. People were shooting the wild pigs. Some were shot and some escaped. We thought that everything was over when suddenly a black sloth bear came out panting in the hot sun. Panting means half the way. Now I will not shoot a sloth bear wantonly. Wantonly means for no good reason, want only. Okay. Now I will not shoot a sloth bear wantonly, but unfortunately for the poor beast, one of my companions did not feel that way about it. Okay, he said that I will not hit a bear without any cause, but my companion didn't feel the same way and he shot the bear. As we watched the fallen animal, we were surprised to see that black fur on its back moved and left the prostrate body. Okay, so the poor beast was there, and the author is saying that I will not hit him without any cause, but the companion did, the fellow man did. And the whole group watched this fallen animal. They were surprised to see the black fur on its back moved and left the prostrate body. Prostrate means how the human beings are. We walk straight, okay? And the animals, they walk on four. Then we saw it was a baby bear, okay? Then we saw that a baby bear that had been riding on its mother back when the sudden shot had killed her. Okay, so the companion, he shot the bear that was a mother bear and it was having a baby that was riding on its back. The little creature ran around its prostrate parent making a pitiful noise. Prostrate means lying on the ground, facing the ground. On force, then the baby bear started screaming, and with pain it was screaming. I ran up to it to attempt a capture. Okay, so what author did? He ran up to the bear to get a hold of him. It scooted into the sugarcane field. Okay, it ran away to the sugarcane field, following it with my companions. Okay, the companions was also after the baby bear. I was at last able to grab it by the scruff of its neck while it snapped and tried to scratch me with its long hooked claws. The narrator somehow managed to grab him, but the bear was scratching the narrator back. It was in a defense posture, attacking the narrator. We put it in one of the gunny bags, okay, one of the bags, the big bag they had. They put it inside the bear. We had brought, and when I got back to Bangalore, I duly presented it to my wife. So what happened? When the narrator went back to Bangalore from Mysore, he presented the bear to his wife. She was delighted. She was overjoyed. She at once put a colored ribbon around its neck, and after describing the cub was a boy, she christened it Bruno. Christened means when you name someone, it is called christening. Okay. Some part of the world, in West to be precise, the name, the first name that we have, like I have Aman, so the first name is called the Christian name. Okay, so they christened it Bruno, as it was a boy. Bruno soon took to drinking milk from a bottle. It was but a step further, and within a very few days, he started eating and drinking everything else. So Bruno started off with drinking milk from a bottle, and later on he began eating everything that was around. And everything is the right word, for he ate porridge. Okay, he started eating porridge. Porridge is dalia, of course, made from any ingredients, vegetables, fruit, nut, meat, especially pork. Okay, especially pork he loved. Curry and rice, regardless of the condiments and chilies. Condiments means spices, breads, eggs, chocolates, sweets, pudding, ice cream, whatever you give him, he will eat. Or whatever you will not give him, he will also eat that. It will also eat that. As for drink, milk, tea, coffee, lime juice, everything was for Bruno. Aerated water, buttermilk, beer, alcoholic liquor, and in fact anything liquid, it all went down with relish. So Bruno was a very very good bear. It never said no to anything. Whatever was around, it will eat, and that is a good thing also and a bad thing also. The bear became very attached to our two Alsatians. Okay, Alsatian dogs were there. So Bruno became very fond of them, to all the children of the tenants. The tenants were there living in the bungalow, so he became very close to them as well. He was left quite free in his younger days and spent his time in playing. Okay, so in his younger days, it used to play a lot, running into the kitchen and going to sleep in our beds. So the author says that it was a free beast, free animal, and it used to roam around everywhere in the kitchen and everywhere around, and used to sleep on our beds as well, and used to play in the younger days. One day an accident befell him. Okay, what happened? One day one accident happened with him. The author put down poison, barium carbonate, to kill the rats and mice that had got into my library. So the author because of a lot of mice and rats were there, so he put some barium carbonate, the poison, to kill them. And what happened? Any guesses? What would have happened? Bruno entered the library as he often did, and he ate some of the poison. So what Bruno did? He entered the library and ate some of the poison. Paralysis set into the extent that he could not stand on his feet. So sudden paralysis attack was there for Bruno because he ate the entire poison. But he dragged himself on his stumps to my wife, who called me. Okay, he was dragging himself. He was trying to crawl. He was trying to reach to his owner, the wife. I guessed what had happened. Off I rushed in the car to the vet's residence. A case of poisoning, tame bear, barium carbonate, what to do. Okay, so he told everything to the veterinary, the doctor, that a bear, he has taken barium carbonate, and what to do now. Out came his medical books and a feverish. Okay, the veterinary doctor, he took out his books and everything, and a feverish reference to index began. What poison did you say, sir? Barium carbonate? Barium salts, barium carbonate, symptoms, paralysis, treatment, injections of... Just a minute, sir. I'll bring my syringe and the medicine. So the doctor started searching that what could be done for Bruno. I'll bring my syringe and the medicine, he said. A dash back to the car, Bruno still floundering about on his stumps, but clearly weakening rapidly. Some vomiting, heavy breathing with heaving flanks and gaping mouth. Okay, so Bruno was heavily breathing. He was having difficulty to be all right. He was having heavy breathing, plus he was very weak. He was getting weak. Hold him, everybody, in goes the hypodermic, Bruno squeals. 10 Celsius of the antidote enters his system without a drop being wasted. So the doctor put the syringe and 10 minutes later, condition unchanged. Another 10 cc injection and 10 minutes later, breathing less stertorous. Okay. Stertorous breathing means noisy breathing. Okay. Stertorous breathing means a very very uncalm breathing, very noisy breathing. He cannot stand yet. 30 minutes later, Bruno gets up and has a great feed. Okay, 30 minutes later, what he did? He has some food. He looks at us disdainfully, as much as to say, what's barium carbonate to a big black bear like me? Bruno is still eating. So even after going through so much, he was still having the food, and he was acting like, what can a little piece of poison do to a big bear like me? Another time he found nearly 1 gallon of old engine oil, which I had drained from the stump of the stud baker and was keeping as a weapon against the inroads of termites. Okay, so Bruno once drank off the engine oil, okay, that was kept by the narrator for killing the termites. He promptly drank the lot, but it had no ill effects whatever. Bruno drank the whole lot, but still, because of his big body, he was very huge, it didn't have any effect. The months rolled on, and Bruno had grown many times the size he was when he came. So months passed and Bruno became very huge. He was twice or thrice the size he was when he first came to the house. He had equaled the Alsatians in height and had even outgrown them. Two Alsatians were there. Alsatians are a very tall breed of dogs, and he had outgrown those Alsatians as well. But was just as sweet, just as mischievous, just as playful. He was huge, he grew up, but he was just as naughty, playful, mischievous like he was during his younger age. And he was very fond of us all. So he was very attached to the family. Above all, he loved my wife and she loved him too. So what happened? Bruno became big, but he was a kid still inside him, and he loved the narrator's wife. She had changed his name from Bruno to Baba, a Hindustani word signifying a small boy. So Bruno was again named, and his name was changed to Baba. And he could do a few tricks too at the command, Baba wrestle or Baba box. He vigorously tackled anyone who came forward for a rough and tumble, give him a stick and say, Baba, hold gun. And he pointed the stick at you. So Baba used to act like he's boxing. He used to play with the stick. He used to wrestle. So everything that was asked to Baba, he used to do. Where's baby? And he immediately produced and cradled affectionately a stump of wood which he had carefully concealed in his straw bed. So if you will ask Bruno that, Baba, that where is the baby? He would act like he is cradling, okay? He act like he is having a small baby in a stump of wood which he had carefully concealed in his straw bed. But because of the tenants' children, poor Bruno or Baba had to be kept chained most of the time. But because there were kids around of the tenants, Bruno had to be chained every time because it was a bit risky for the kids. Then my son and I advised my wife, and friends advised her too, to give Baba to the zoo at Mysore. So everyone, the narrator, his son, the friends around, they advised the lady to give Baba or Bruno away to the zoo at Mysore because it can be risky for the small kids or to us as well. He was getting too big to keep at home. After some weeks of such advice, she at last consented. Okay, she at last agreed that okay, Baba can be given off to the zoo. After some weeks of such advice, she at last consented, and hastily, and before she could change her mind, a letter was returned to the curator. Curator means the person in charge of the zoo. A letter was sent to the curator of the zoo. Did he want a tame bear for his collection? They asked him that, do you want a tame bear? He replied, yes. The zoo sent for a cage from Mysore in a lorry, a distance of 87 miles, and Baba was packed off. Okay, so here the story part 1 concludes. We have seen that how beautifully the relation of Baba and the author's wife is shown in the story. How Baba is a very mischievous bear, how he drank off poison and engine oil, how he plays with the narrator's wife, how he box, how he wrestle, how he, when he's asked that where is the baby, he acts like he is having a cradle. So everything is there. But later on, because of the safety of everyone and Baba was getting big, he was sent off to the zoo at Mysore.
So the part 1 of the chapter is over here. And together we have seen that how Bruno is and what a lovely creature Bruno is. And in the next part, we are going to see that what happens next with it. Okay, so till that time you have to do the word meanings of the chapter that I have asked you to do so. And if any confusions are there related to the chapter, feel free to ask. Just go through the story, enjoy the story. We are explaining you the stories through the lectures. The teachers are making a lot of efforts for you. But you also, for my subject, literature, you have to read it also. Don't just watch the videos or don't just watch any other YouTube video. Firstly, you should read the story on your own from the book. Then you will enjoy the story more. So, I am Aman from DPS Advani Ramachaw. You are watching Video Classes. We will meet